Maria, can you please type it in the chat window? You're not been able to locate.
No.
Okay. So can you see more button, more option? Yeah, click on that. There you get to see chat. Okay. Can you see it now? Chat option? I don't know what's wrong here. Oh, Rehma has hi Anushree. Is it Anushree? Maria, I can't hear you exactly. Would be great if you can find the chat option and type it in there. Not able to hear you. Please try check your mic or something.
Okay.
Not really. Hi Maria, welcome to this session. How have you been? I can't hear you, Maria. It's better if you can just type in and I'll speak. Is that okay with you? Okay, great. Cool. So last time we did SEO, right? Which is search engine optimization. Do you remember? Yes, great. So let's do a quick recap of what we did in our last session. Okay, so now please tell me what is search engine? Please tell me what is search engine, Maria? Yes, search engine. Have you done any sort of revision or the topics that we have covered? Not yet. Oh, but you need to do the revision side by side. Okay, you haven't received the recording. Oh, okay. So you remember anything? Okay. So you remember on page? What is on page? What is on page? On page is when we post our ad in our own website. It's not ad basically, Maria. It's the tag. Tag. Yes. Okay, like title. You remember title tag? Yes. Okay, can you tell me how many characteristics it has? The word limit, we need to specify the word limit for title tag. Oh, okay. So, Maria, you need to practice all these. So, like title will be okay. I'll just open the document. I'm sharing it right now. Okay, start sharing screen. Okay, Maria. So here, can you see the title tag that we have spoke about in our last class? It should be 50 to 70 word limit, and the title end by the brand name or the website name.
Website name, yeah.
Yeah, and use of pipe symbol and focus keyword. Yeah, you remember?
Yes. Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you now properly, Maria. Great. So next tag was the meta description.
Okay.
Okay, you remember meta description?
Yes.
Okay, so it will be from 130 to 156 limits, and it will be a focus keyword. Okay, it should include the keyword. Hope you remember the keywords and all.
Yes. We have to go, I think, for the keyword planner, right?
Yes, exactly. Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Preeti, I have a question.
Sure, go ahead.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yes, because for like like for our like for us, like an advertising agency, if we have a client who wants like what we call this to for SEO, like if they're still new and they want SEO for their website, so do you think how much is the range of price that's like for this one we need to charge for the client or something like that?
Yes, very valid question. So yeah, so the pricing would really depend on the number of keywords that you are going to work on.
Okay.
So I'll tell you here. Pricing for SEO. Okay. This is your question.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep. So let's say the first and the foremost parameter is the number of keywords that they want to rank.
Okay.
How competitive is the keyword is?
Okay.
The keyword is. So as I shown you in the keyword planner, you can see how competitive keyword is, whether it is high, low, medium. You remember?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So if it is high level, then you can charge more to client. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If it is medium, then you can reduce the cost. Low, you can again reduce the cost. Okay. If you are starting with, just to give you, and I can tell you in rupees basically.
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
Not a problem, or dollar also.
Maybe dollar, yeah. I think that would be better.
Okay. So basically for, if you see, companies will come to you and ask for 30, 40, 50 keywords, right? That they want to rank on. But you need to make them understand that, see, we can't go for initially at this stage, we can't go for all those keywords, okay? Because it's gonna take a really long time to rank websites on a one keyword, okay? It takes 3 months minimum.
Okay.
Minimum 3 months to 1 year maximum. Depending on competition of the keyword, competitive keyword.
Okay.
So these are the parameters on which the cost will vary. Now, customer, if say you please rank my 30 keywords, you need to make sure that you make clear this to client that initially you should start with at least 6 to 7 keywords only. Okay. Once they start ranking, then start working on other keywords, other set of keywords. Okay.
Okay. If
target all those,
because I remember
you will not reach anywhere.
Yeah, because I remember you mentioned last time there's only minimum keywords that we can use, right?
No, you can use a maximum, like more keywords also to rank. That is basically per web page.
Okay. Yes.
Per web page. But looking at the complete website, they can go, like if there are 10 web pages, and then you can imagine if 5 keywords for each web page, okay?
Mm.
Keywords you need to work on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
okay. Back to what you're explaining.
Yeah.
So for the 30 keywords, initially we can only give 6 to 7 keywords, as you mentioned.
Yes, you can ask client, it's better to start with the priority. Set the priority of the keywords, start working on those keywords. Once they start ranking, then immediately start working on other keywords so that even clients see the results coming. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right? And they will, you can charge $150 to $200 for these keywords, minimum.
This is for the high keywords or medium or low?
Medium, I would say medium.
Okay. Yes.
Low keywords, you can charge $150.
Okay,
for low keywords, like $120 to $150. And that also depends on the competition, how competitive the keyword is, okay? If it is high level, then you can charge more, like $300. Okay. And these this is for a number of keywords like 6 to 7. You can go up to 10 keywords with this cost, up to 10, maximum 10 keywords with this cost. Not, don't go more
okay.
than
that.
Okay.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. So this is something we charge, like we do have our own agency by the name of Yoke Creations.
Okay.
So this is the amount okay. we charge from our customer. This is what I am telling you, that what we charge. But there are mm-hmm. companies in the market who charge at low price also or at maximum or high price also. That really varies. Mm.
Yes, yes. Okay, no problem. Yeah, makes sense.
Okay, great. So yeah, coming back here. So we have covered all these tags with you, keywords, meta robot, URL naming, all tag. Hope you remember all these. You remember
yes.
keyword density?
Keyword density is the number, I think, of the keywords that should you put in the URL of your website, something like that. I that's what I remember.
The keyword that you're going to add within web page.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, web page. Yeah.
Yeah. So when you write the content of your web page, make sure that it should be 100 words. There should be one keyword only on every 100 word. One keyword. So 1% less. Okay. If you go for more, it will be called keyword stuffing.
Keyword stuffing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's better to use more of synonyms, right? So I have also shared the process for SEO. Like first indexing will be done. Like the spider will come to your website, gather the information and make their database, store the information and then process.
Okay.
Yeah. Keywords, we have talked about keywords. Focus keyword, anchor text. You remember anchor text? Maria?
Yes.
Yeah, you remember what is anchor text?
Yeah, I think this is the when you open another page and you see that there's a web page advertisement on that page, particular page that you
it's
open.
It's a clickable link, basically.
Yeah, clickable. Yeah.
Clickable link. Okay. So you can see the text where you can click and it will land you to some other page, whether it's within.
Yeah, like for example, if you open like a Wikipedia. And there's
a lot of links there in Wikipedia. Exactly. Mm-hmm. I've shown you that example. Great. So inbound link, you remember the link building?
Link building.
Yeah, number yes. of links. Yes. I have shared this tool with you where you can check the link backlinks a company is getting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So that was about SEO, and also I've shared the submission, social bookmarking submission.
Yes.
Yeah.
I remember.
Video submission, image submission, directory submission. Okay, so when once you receive the recording, then would be great if you can go through the recording, yeah?
Yes, yes, yes.
Then
hopefully I'll receive them very, very soon.
Sure. Great. Just a sec. Okay. So we have covered the theoretical part of the ad campaign.
Yes.
You remember?
Yeah, I remember.
Okay.
The Google AdWords.
Google AdWords. So there are two type of ads. One is the text ad and the other is the shopping ad.
Yes.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. And display ads?
Display ads. Yeah, yeah.
Display ads are those ads which are shown on any other website but not on search engine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Okay, so today I'm going to show you. You want me to go through this again, the ad part from beginning?
Not really. Like the important points only, I think.
Okay.
Can we discuss?
So yeah, in display ads, like you can create three type of ads: text ad, video ad, image ad.
Mm.
Okay, and when you create a display ad, there are four parties involved, like publisher, like NDTV.
Mm.
I've shown you the example of NDTV. Is a
yeah.
Remember?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. So this is the example. Then advertiser will make payment to Google, and then Google will pay to NDTV, as I've shared with you. Okay, these are the amounts
okay.
we shared. Then quickly, we have done talked about Google campaign account, how you are going to create a campaign in Google account. Okay, so these are.
Priti, I have a question.
Sure.
If we want to do the Google AdWords, right? We need to sign in our, like, to make an account for Google AdWords.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So. Because actually I'm trying to do this in our own company, like last time I'm trying to do an account for to make an account for Google AdWords, but it says there when I opened our this Google Ad login something, it says there that this is not included in
your voice is not properly coming. Sorry, Maria.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Can you hear me now clearly?
Yeah.
So when I make an account for the Google AdWords, mm-hmm. it says there that it is not included on the subscription or contract that we have purchased with, because we are, I think we have this account under G Suits.
Okay.
Do you know this? Yeah. So I did not, I cannot make an account because that's what it says there. Like it's not included in your subscription. So my question is, do we really have like to include this Google AdWords account for our subscription or something
no,
like
no,
that?
Not exactly. Mm. You can log in through your Gmail ID basically.
Yes. Using my Gmail ID. Okay.
So you can directly, once you come on Google AdWords, then mm-hmm. you log in with your Gmail ID and you will land on the AdWords account. It will not ask you for the subscription part. I will not.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then do we have to like pay something for the registration on this one or the, yeah?
No, you do not, don't have to pay for the registration to make ads on Google AdWords.
Create
campaigns and pay for those ads.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so only when we are making a campaign, that's the time we are being charged.
Okay.
Yeah? That's it. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. So now we are going to do this Google AdWords.
Mm.
Okay. So in case you have any doubt, any query, then please go ahead before we start.
Yeah, it's fine.
On SEO, do you have any query?
No. For now, no.
Okay. I can share this document also with you because this
is
the one that I have created while giving you a training.
Okay. Yes. That would be great.
Sure. Thank you. Okay. So now, coming to Google okay, so when I click on sign in, you want me to sign in by your credentials?
I think so.
Yeah,
would it be fine.
Mm. Okay, so if you can share, if you don't mind sharing your credentials, then definitely I can log in by your
okay. So the email is the same, Maria.
Okay, just a sec. Yeah.
At INH.
Sorry?
Indian Nancy Hotel.
NH.
Yes, ADV.
adv.com.
Okay. Clear? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, you can type in the password.
Okay, can you share, unshare the screen?
Okay, just a sec. Okay. I don't know whether we can share. We make you the remote control. Okay, I'll just give you the control. Okay, now you can type in.
One second, because I still cannot type. One second.
Just a second.
What should I click, Preeti? Because I still cannot type.
Oh, you just click on enter password, this area, and type.
Yes, but yeah, but I cannot type. I already click enter your password area, but I cannot type anything.
Right, okay, found. I have given the control to you, just a sec.
Because it says here, original size, give up remote control, annotate, exit full screen. What should I click here?
Stop. I have given you the control. Try doing it now.
Because until now I can see still your screen.
Yeah, you can, you just be able to see my screen, but you can move your mouse and keyboard. You can use your mouse and keyboard.
Yes, that's what I'm doing right now. Ah, okay.
Yeah, just try to move your mouse and get the cursor there.
Can you please accept me? I request a remote control.
I have done.
Share. Click to start the mouse or keyboard on the shared. Where's the shared button?
You don't need to share the screen or something. Just type. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing, Preeti, because I think last time Nick also did the same thing.
Okay.
I was able to like put my password on the same account, but now I cannot type anything. I don't know what's happening.
Oh, okay.
Can you just please recheck again?
Let me just see. I have given the remote control.
Maybe you have to stop sharing first, like stop your sharing so I can type here.
No, it's just that I just share the remote control with you, and you know, you can just type in, you can use your keyboard and the mouse, and only you will be able to type in.
It's not giving me the like even if I click on the blank
cursor, try moving the cursor.
No.
Mouse. Yeah, it's coming now. Yeah, type in.
Okay. It's coming now.
Yeah.
1 second.
Okay, so it says this device is not recognized. Okay, so we need to have the confirmation. Let's verify a call. Is it okay if you get a call or get a...
No, it's not my mobile number. It's my boss mobile number. So I think we're just going to use your account.
Okay, sure. In case you have any other account, then we can use that, or we can use my account.
Okay. I have another account, Gmail account, if you want.
Yeah,
but I don't think even if it's my personal account.
Yeah,
can we use it?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely.
Okay,
then I can give you my email ad on the chat box, and I'll just type again the. Ah, okay.
Yeah, you have the control. Type in. Okay, even your is not registered, like it is not. You remember your security question?
I don't really think so. Let me check first.
Maria, you are in Dubai, yeah, right?
Yes, I'm in Dubai.
Okay, you belong to Dubai only, or you belong to some other country?
Currently, I'm staying in Dubai, but like my home country is from the Philippines.
Philippines.
That's okay. Why, maybe, yeah.
Great.
I cannot remember. I think we can just use your email account.
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Not a problem. Okay, let me just see. Okay, so this is my account. Okay.
Okay.
So this is how this, I just want to, you know, go for with the fresh one so that you can could see the settings or the things that will happen when you first log into this.
Mm-hmm.
So because I'm
okay.
already using it. So we can do one
thing.
Let's say if I can log in from my other account, which I haven't used earlier. That would be.
Yes, that would be great.
Okay, so now can you see here? This is the first page that you're going to get.
Okay.
Okay, so it is different from the one that we previously logged in from. Okay, so it gives you some how you can start, like you can choose your budget, create your ad, select keywords, enter your billing information. These are the things that you need to make sure before starting. Okay.
Okay.
So let's click on create your first campaign, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, so this is the page that I am on. Yeah, this is going to be the first campaign.
Okay.
So let's name it. You want to create a campaign for your own company or let's...
Yeah, I think...
Like flower company, luxury rose or
luxury rose. We can,
Okay. So let's say Valentine.
Or we can use my current company.
Sorry.
Yeah, the luxury rose. Yes.
Okay.
You can use it.
Okay. So let's say the Valentine is around, and now we need to run a campaign. Okay. So let's say we'll just type in here Valentine. Campaign. We are just naming it. Okay, Valentine campaign 2017. Make sense?
Okay. Yes. So the campaign name is basically the title of your campaign.
Sorry, the company name.
No, no, no. I mean the campaign name.
Yeah.
Is it basically the title of your campaign?
Exactly.
Is it,
okay. Yeah.
Okay.
For which you're okay. running the campaign. You are going to give a unique name so that you can just, look later also. There can be multiple campaigns at one point in time. So make sure you give a unique name to each campaign.
Okay, sure.
Okay, yeah.
But does it like contain like should like a minimum or maximum characters or something like
no,
that? Or no,
nothing like that. Nothing like that. It's just a name. It should be a descriptive, like a small name. Okay. There's no limit as set here. Okay. So now the next part is that we are going to look at the type of campaign that we are going to create. Okay. So I have told you. These are the types, different types that we can create. One is the search network with display select. Can you now relate? Can you relate search network and display select?
Is it like the same like the NDTV and we have this juice company? Exactly. Is it some similar to that? Okay.
Yeah. So search network is running your ad on search engine like Google. Okay, that is called search ad, as I made you clear also in my previous class. Okay, and the display ad is the ad which comes on different websites.
But Priti, can you choose the specific ad which your website will display to other website or no? It's under Google AdWords discretion.
Different ad, I didn't get you. Can you please repeat? Pardon you.
Okay, so you mean to say in this display network, you mentioned that our campaign will be displayed to other website pages, in some other website pages.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so can we select a specific website where we can...
Yes, definitely. So you can select the website or you can also select the type of website, whether you want to display your ad within news related website or educational related website, software related website. So there are certain categories which are available. First you can select the category and then you can also select the name of the website.
Okay, so we'll do the selection first.
Yes. So here if we select search network with display select, that means we are going to create an ad on both the platforms, search engine also and display network also.
Okay.
Both the options. And in case we want to just create the ad and if we only want to create an ad on search network, that is on Google, then we select search network only.
Okay.
And if we only want to create display network ad, then we select display network only.
Okay.
And if we want to create shopping ads that I have shown you on the search engine platform, right? Shopping ads.
Yes.
Yeah. For that, we are going to select this option.
Okay.
We are creating video ads for YouTube. Then we are going to select video on YouTube for YouTube.
Okay,
and if we are going to create campaign, app campaign, like mobile apps, okay, then
select
this option.
Creepy, the shopping ads, if I'm not mistaken, this is like...
Your voice, Maria, sorry.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, better.
Is it clear now? Okay.
Yeah.
The shopping ads which you mentioned, if I'm not... mistaken, this is the ads when you like type iPhone by 7, it comes with
the product and the pricing. It is also called product listing ads, that is PLA.
I remember that. And for the video, video ad, this is only suitable when you're making a YouTube campaign or what?
Yes, only YouTube campaign, for YouTube only.
Okay. But if I'm going to search in Google, it will show only like, and it will go for a landing page directly on the YouTube or...
No, it will be shown only on YouTube. Okay, if people are searching the video on YouTube, then your video will show up, not on Google.
Okay.
Okay, makes sense?
Yes, makes sense.
Okay. So currently, to start with, we are just going to start to create search network ad only. Okay.
Okay.
So now when we select search network only, here we get to see standard ad, like let's say keyword targeted text ad showing on Google search results. Yes, we just want to create a standard ad with a set of keywords, okay, and which will show on Google search engine.
Okay.
Okay, if we select all the features and options available for search network, see, on there is a big search network like Google, and then Google has their own partners. Okay, if you want to go for that, then we click on all features.
But is it expensive than the standard?
No, no. It's just having all the features, yes.
Okay, so like for our company, what would you prefer, the standard or the all features?
Yes, to start with standard.
Okay.
Okay. Now, coming back here on the networks. Can you see the same point there? To choose different networks, edit the same edit the campaign type above or create a new campaign. So we want to run our campaign on Google search network only, not on search partners. Okay, so we can deselect.
Okay.
Search partners means Google Business, Google Places, Google Maps, all these Google, you know, the partners of Google website. But we just want to create an ad on search network, let's only on Google, not other partners.
Okay.
Okay. Getting it clear?
Yes, yes, yes. Is it the same as the all features? Can you please
go
on top again?
Yeah, yeah.
Like the all features available for the search network and in the include search partner, is it the same, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So we just deselect that and we'll just go with search network only.
Okay.
Okay, and now add devices like ads will show on all eligible devices by default, as it shows devices like mobile, laptop, desktop. Okay, so when we create the ad, the this will be shown on all devices by default. Okay, so there is no option to select right now. It's just the message they are giving. So here now you can select the location also. Okay, where you want to target this campaign. Okay, so let me just show you. If I select all countries, you can select simple all countries and territories. So it will be shown across the world. And right now, as I am in India and my account is in India, so it is showing me the India option. But when you create, it might show you Dubai.
Okay.
So if I select, let me choose. So I'll just say Dubai. Okay, here I can select Dubai and I can click on add. Okay, so you can see based on targeted locations, you may want to target pages that user use these interface languages. So you can see because the language is Arabic, so you can select language also.
Okay.
This is the suggested point, target suggested languages. Arabic and English based on the location that we have selected. Okay,
so
showing that. And if you want to go advanced search, click on advanced search. Is there any
what do you mean by this?
Sorry?
What do you mean by this advanced search?
Yeah, advanced location search. So you can target. So within Dubai, let's say is there any area in Dubai?
Like, let's say, Media City, something like that.
Sorry, Media City.
Media City, yeah.
Media City, Dubai. No matches found. There is one place. that called? I even don't remember now.
Have you visited Dubai before?
Yes, yes. I stayed there for 15, 20 days.
Like only for a vacation?
No. It was for work purpose only.
Oh. maybe you can try. And what's common place?
Let's say Abu Dhabi. Okay, let's go to.
Yeah.
Okay, Abu Dhabi we have selected. Okay, now I can also do. Do you remember any code there? PIN code? Zip code? Is there any zip thing?
No, I couldn't remember.
Postal code?
I don't know.
Okay,
I don't know about any postal code in Abu Dhabi. Maybe Dubai, yeah.
Okay, you can tell me Dubai code.
58508.
Is this? Oh, sorry, no matches.
No?
No.
I don't know.
Okay, so I'll just show you India code. So let's say this is one code. I didn't know matches. See, this is one code of India, Delhi. Okay, I'll select that. Now, I want radius targeting. Okay, so when I select radius targeting, I'll just select the area here. Let's say, can you see this Kirti Nagar coming here, showing here Kirti?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just type in there and I'll just specify 5 kilometers. You can either take miles or kilometers. So now system is showing me this from Kirti Nagar. I want to target 5 kilometers. Okay. So now as your business is local business,
okay. This
is very relevant for you now because flower business is a relevant business, local business. When you are going to deliver flowers within a particular range area, right? You're not going to go for every, I don't know how.
Yes.
But it will be for particular kilometers only, like till 10 kilometers from this location. Yeah. So where are you putting up right now?
Which one is, for example, which one is a more better way to target your audience? Like, for example, you have two options, right? The kilometer and the miles.
Yes, kilometer.
Do you think... Yeah. Do you think miles is like more appropriate because it will cover like more places or what?
I think no. It really depends on you. If you want to specify in miles or if you want to specify in kilometer. If you want to cover that really depends on you how you want to specify. Okay.
And we really need to put the postal code, right?
No, you can tell me the location where you are putting up right now or your location.
In Dubai?
Yeah.
Let's say a Business Bay.
Sorry, Business Bay?
Yeah, Business Bay.
Yeah, I've been to this area.
Dubai, something like that.
Search. Okay, now can you see this?
Yes.
Select 10 kilometers. So you can cover more area.
See, yes.
This is the one. Okay. So now your ad will be shown within 10 kilometers of Business Bay, Dubai.
Okay.
So you can do this target, you can target within that area, which is really
okay.
You can add and click on done. So see, it is added. Business Bay, 10 kilometers.
Okay,
in case you want to remove or exclude something. Okay, let's say I just remove Abu Dhabi. And now when I find Abu Dhabi and I'll say exclude. I don't want my ad to run in Abu Dhabi. I don't want to read
that.
Okay.
So if I am in Abu Dhabi and I am going to search for this campaign for my company, I cannot find this.
No, if people are going to search for the flower shop or something, they will not be able to find your ad campaign, because that is not relevant even to people there, right? If they call you to for order, you will not address those orders, right? Because you can't deliver.
Yes.
So there's no point reaching out to those people who are not relevant. So for you, best is go with 10 kilometer around Business Bay, or you can increase the area to 15, 20 kilometers. Okay. And then your ad will be shown within that particular range.
Okay.
Okay. You can exclude also, you can add also. Yeah.
Yeah. But aside from this 10 kilometer radius, we can, people all in Dubai can see my ad, right? Even like I only mentioned Business Bay.
No, if you want to look for all the people in Dubai, then select Dubai.
Okay.
Okay, this Dubai. Then,
or can I just add Dubai?
Yeah.
Because, see, it's like we have three places here.
Okay.
Yeah, so Dubai, Business Bay, and India. Right?
Okay.
So these people
I can remove India. India, and now these two areas. Dubai also, you can select Dubai, completely Dubai, then you don't need to select Business Bay. Okay. But if you just want to target Business Bay 10 kilometers, then you can select that only.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, it's clear now.
And the option to select the radius targeting you will get within advanced search. Yeah.
Okay.
So when you are going to create an ad, create at your end and select the advanced search, do the target radius targeting by the postal code. You can check the postal code for Dubai and then try to find it. Okay. So you can go to that nitty gritty, you can go to that point of postal code also. So now the languages they have suggested, you can go for Arabic or English till you can edit. See, these are the languages which are available. So if you want to select Arabic, you can select Arabic, or if you just want to show to people with English language, then select English.
Okay,
make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So now the next is the very important part, is the bid strategy. Okay. So it's gonna take time to explain now. Let me open the document. Have you heard about bidding or auction that is happening?
For Google AdWords?
Yeah.
No.
Okay, so in Google AdWords, first step, we have named the campaign. Yep. We have selected the type of campaign. Okay, so I'll just mention these are the steps. Okay, then type of campaign, then we have selected the location.
Okay.
Then language. Yes. Any doubt in these areas?
No. It's clear now.
Moving ahead, the fifth part is select doing the bidding. You understand what is bidding?
Yes.
In normal language, you might have seen a lot of movies where people are bidding or doing auction for things, like for home or for things like car. That really happens. Have you seen?
Yeah.
I don't know how movies are made in Philippines, but in Bollywood, we get to see all those things.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I only witnessed bidding for business, something like if you who plays the best bid, then this project will go to that specific company
agency. Yeah, got it. So see, that bidding is also hidden. You don't know how much that person is bidding, right?
Okay. Yes, for sure.
Yeah. Similarly, in here also, you don't know how much your competitor is bidding for the project. Oh, sorry, not for the project, for the keyword basically. Okay. So here, there are mainly two options, mainly I'm talking about. One is the manual. Okay. So base manual, and the other is the automated. Right.
Okay.
Manual CPC, which is called manual cost per click.
Click, yeah.
Yes. Okay. Okay, and this is automated as maximize clicks. Okay.
Okay.
So now when you run a campaign, you run a campaign with some objective, okay? First, you need to decide the objective of your campaign. Okay, let's see the objective of your campaign, right? So it can either be number one, to receive more traffic on your website, receive more traffic on your website, okay? You want more traffic on your website. Secondly, you want more sales or conversion.
The meaning of conversion is sales.
Yes,
because I always hear conversion, but I don't know what's the meaning of
conversion. Means you got the customer, that customer has purchased, is it's a sale.
Okay
yeah, you want more sales or conversions basically. Okay. It's called CPA. That is cost per acquisition. Yes?
What do you mean? The same. Yeah.
The same. Acquisition. Spending. No, it's not the same. Acquisition.
I think it's AC.
ACQUI.
Yeah. Okay. ACQUI.
Yeah, thank you so much.
No problem.
Okay, so you need to have the objective first clear, whether you want to receive more traffic on your website or you want more sales. Okay?
Should I mention this objective like when I'm making a campaign?
No, you don't need to mention, but you need to keep in mind that this is your objective. You should be clear. Mm-hmm. Okay, what you're looking for from this campaign.
Okay.
Yeah, based on that only you're going to set your bid.
Yeah.
Okay. So now.
Okay.
I'll come to this. Now in manual CPC, like cost per click here, you are allowed to set the bid, okay? You can do bidding at your end and you can keep changing it as and when you want. Changing as and when you want, okay?
Okay.
So in manual CPC, you just bid for the keyword manually. You write the bid and you change at any point in time. Okay.
Okay.
Whereas in automated maximize clicks system, like AdWords system, will automatically set the bid for you.
Okay.
Okay, based on your budget. Okay. Daily budget, you specify the daily budget also in bidding. Okay.
Okay.
So next you also have maximize CPA, cost per acquisition. That means you want more conversions or say,
okay,
then you select this.
Okay.
Bid. Okay, coming back to AdWords so that it gets more clear to you now. So these are the options which are available. Okay, so if you people mainly go for manual CPC, okay, mostly.
Yeah, because say for example, if my business is not really like that kind of big, so I'll go for this manual CPC.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so you set your own maximum cost per click. You just select what you are willing to pay maximum for the keywords. Okay. Okay, so let's say I'm willing to pay 100 and my budget is, okay, let's say 50, 100 is a lot more, but I'm not gonna.
What do you mean by default bid, pretty?
Sorry?
What do you mean by default bid?
Default bid is like how much you're willing to pay for the keyword. So let's say if someone comes and click on your ad, click on that. On that click, you are going to pay 100 rupees to Google.
Okay.
Cost per click. CPC is cost per click. So anyone who clicks on your ad, you are going to pay Google this 100 rupees. You are willing to pay 100, which is maximum. Okay.
Okay.
It can be low also. System can charge you less also, but maximum you are willing to pay is 100. Okay, you can't go beyond that.
Okay.
And you have set the budget 1,000 per day. So how many clicks you are going to get? 10 clicks per day. Okay. And after those clicks, your ad will stop.
Sorry, for the budget, you mentioned 1,000 per day.
Yes.
Okay, so for 1,000, how many clicks am I getting again? Sorry,
10 clicks. You can see this. You are bidding for 100 rupees per click. Mm-hmm. Okay, and you get 10, then your budget will be over. 10 into 100, 1,000.
Okay,
and when you get 10 clicks, your budget will be over on 1,000 rupees and your ad will stop for that particular day.
Okay. But it's automatically renewed on the next day, or should I?
A lot of noise. Sorry, now can you please?
Sorry. If 10 people click on my website, right? Okay. And then after that, you said my ad will stop for that day.
Yes.
On the next day, on the next day, does my ad will appear again or what?
Yes, it will appear again.
Okay.
Time duration till when you want to showcase your ad to be run. Let's say for a month.
Okay.
Yes, we will come to that.
Okay.
So this is
the 100 rupees bid, is this per day, right?
Yeah, per click, 100.
Okay, per click, sorry.
Yeah, 1,000 is per day.
Okay. Clear now.
Okay. So this is manual, which is used mostly, and many advertisers use manual only, okay? Then we have automated.
Yes.
If someone don't have any time, okay, if they don't have any time to spend and come on Google AdWords and keep looking for how it is doing, and you can change the bid, you don't have time to keep changing the bid, then people select automated clicks, maximize clicks. Okay. In that case, AdWords automatically set to help you get many clicks as possible within your budget. Okay. So here you set the budget 1,000 per day, then AdWords will automatically set the bid for you and they try to get you maximum clicks within that budget.
But you mentioned it's the same 10 clicks, right? For this one. If you're going to have a 1,000 budget and you chose the maximized clicks,
because
is it the same
you're
getting 10 clicks?
Because I have given the bid there, but now if I'll give the authority to AdWords to do the bidding, then it can possible that they get me bid in 50 rupees, 70 rupees. If 50 is the bid, then I can get 20 clicks. Okay.
Okay. 20 clicks.
Yeah. And you also time doing that. You can also, when you select manual CPC, you can also set bid for 50 rupees at initial level. And if you're not getting click, then you change the bid to 100 or 80. Okay. And then accordingly, you will get the clicks.
Okay.
Okay. And similarly, if you set tag.
But Preeti, if you go.
Sorry. Yeah. Your voice, I'm not been able.
Yeah. If you're going to. Hello.
Yeah. Yeah. Please.
Hello.
Yeah. Yeah. Go ahead.
Yes. If I'm going to what do you call this? Make a bid, right? Like, for example, 100 rupees is my budget per day. Does it guarantee me that my web page will appear on the first page of the search engine?
No, there is no guarantee.
No?
No, no. If you bid 100, okay. Let's say if you bid 100, I told you in my last class that it will also depend on the quality score. You remember the quality score that we have talked about?
Yeah.
I'll just come show you
quality
that.
Score.
Quality score. I can't see the quality score. Have I told you? Yeah.
It's already here.
Yeah. This
it's
is already here. Quality
down, score. Down. Yeah.
Yeah. So ad rank will depend. Yeah. One is the bidding and the second is the quality score. For that, you should have a landing page, a relevant landing page, that is your website. You should have an ad copy, relevant ad copy.
Okay.
And click-through rate, number of clicks that you are going to get. Only then your ad will rank.
Okay. Yes.
So, these are the criterias. So it's not only on bidding, it really don't depend on bidding. Once you start making campaigns, when you start viewing the results, then you get to know what is exactly happening, you know. Only practice will make you perfect.
Yeah.
Then only you get to know if you are bidding this much amount for these keywords, then your ad is ranking or not. And if it is not ranking, then what's the reason behind? You start again creating a different ad copy, okay, then you can see whether on this ad copy it is ranking or not, okay. So there are a lot of trials that is going to happen once you start.
Yes.
And if you keep trying creating ad campaigns on different situations or keywords, then only you will get to know what is happening.
Yeah, because actually, like last 2 days back, we have this client have actually running a Google ad campaign. They already have an currently have a Google campaign, but the thing is, they have like low number of clicks they're getting.
Right.
Because, like for example, they are a catering service actually here in Dubai. Okay. If you will go for a general keyword like catering service, you will never see their catering service. But if you will only mention Arabic catering service, then that's the time you will see their ad on the first page of the search engine. Mm-hmm. So do you think the keyword is the problem of this?
I think there can be a problem of keyword or probably the ad copy they are creating. Ad copy has to be relevant, like the content they are writing in the ads and the landing page, whether the website is relevant or not, or the amount of bidding he's doing, he needs to check the competitor. Like you can go to keyword planner and you can see how much the keyword is bid. So as I'll show you here, keyword planner. So keyword planner will basically suggest you how much that keyword is, you know, the cost of that keyword, the bid of that keyword, the suggested bid actually, which you can, you know, even go for less or more, but it will give you. So let's say you want me to for catering business, you want to select?
Yeah, for example.
Catering business. Okay. Mm-hmm. The landing page, you have any idea about the website?
I have the website, but I forgot what's the name. 1 second. I'll give you 1 second.
Sure, take your time.
So this is the I will send through chat.
Yeah, type it in the chat, not a problem. Okay, so this is the one. Great. Okay. Is it right?
Yes. Andalus, yeah.
So I'll select dining or food, food and groceries. Is it okay or you want me to select dining? No. That will not go food.
Maybe dining.
Because they are in.
But it's not a grocery.
But again, yeah. Not a nightlife. Food is okay still. Let's select food only.
Okay.
Drinks, food. Only food. Okay. So they have got all big. Okay, we are not going to select just food, all. That's it. Okay, and here I'm going to change the location to Dubai. Okay, because they are going to target Dubai only, and I'm going to remove India. Okay, get ideas. Okay, we are not getting any bid here. Why it is not coming? Probably because the bid has to be in. Catering business. It's giving me rupees. It's not showing me the bid right now for the keywords. Probably people are not targeting these keywords.
Maybe.
Yeah. Okay, let me just say. Select food. Not getting the bid option here. Dubai is there. Date range. Okay. High competition suggested bid. Should give me that option. Let me just see if I can change in settings. Actually, this is opening through my Gmail account, and my Gmail, their country is India, okay? So it's probably that case. It might not be showing me.
Sorry. No problem.
Otherwise, it will show you the cost. Okay, I have landed to campaign page only. The bidding is not showing me.
Pretty. Like, for example, we're doing a campaign, right? I can see the how many clicks I'm getting through this Google AdWords, right?
Yes, yes, definitely. You can see the number of leads, okay, or business or the peak traffic that you are generating from this.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how much Google is deducting from my from my bill or like,
yes, from your from account. My account. The, yeah, yeah, amount. Okay. So for manual is basically actually used the most. Automated is the second one. Okay, when people don't have much time to concentrate or spend much time on bidding, then they go for maximize clicks, not automated, whereas AdWords has the authority. We give authority to AdWords to bid from our side and keep changing the bid, gain more traffic. Okay?
Okay.
So this is also...
So no need to renew this every day?
Sorry?
Like, for example, I want to run this campaign for 5 days.
Yeah.
So within 5 days, even I'm not going to check the reports from my Google AdWords,
can,
it will continuously
check, check at your end. But, you know, there are some people who don't have time to spend on bidding part. They can't keep looking at the ads or the campaign, right? And they don't. They can't come and keep changing the bid. If they are not getting the traffic, they don't get much time to come and change the bid. Okay. Whereas in manual, you can change the bid as you want. Okay. Similarly, we give authority to AdWords to keep changing the bid if they are not getting the traffic or something. Then AdWords will automatically do the things for you.
Mm.
Okay. This is also very much used, yes, for bidding part. Manual and automated maximized clicks are used the most. Okay, still to give the idea here, to still you can give the idea to AdWords that you can pay 100 rupees. Maximum CPC bid here, you can give this optional in automated case. Okay, it's just the option.
Okay.
You're giving an idea to AdWords that this is the amount you are willing to pay. Whereas in manual, how much you set is going to be the fixed one.
Okay.
You getting the difference between automatic and the manual one?
Yes.
Then we have...
For the automatic... Yeah, for the automatic, you're just giving Google the idea of the bid that you want to pay.
Yes, yes. Just the optional. It is optional. It is not mandatory. If you want, you can give. If you don't want, you can't. You don't. Okay? And AdWords will play as he wants, like as the system wants with the bid.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Make sense?
Yes, makes sense.
Okay.
How about the other thing, like the target ROAS, target outcome?
These are actually very much advanced. Okay. I don't want to confuse you. Still, I'll just explain you them. So, firstly, the target search page location is basically if you want your ad to be shown on the first page of Google at the top. Okay, so here you are just performing. It is all automated, firstly. Okay, the bidding is automated. When you select target search page location, you can see here. You select target search page location. These are all automated bid strategies. Select this. Here, system AdWords will basically help you to get the first position. You have informed AdWords that no matter what amount you bid, but please make sure I want to rank top.
Okay.
Okay. Still, you can give the default bid here. So, can you see AdWords automatically sets your bid to increase the chances that your ads appear at the top of the page or on the first page or of the search result.
Okay.
So the charges will go up. You can select anywhere on the first result page or top of the search result page.
Page.
Yes. Making sense? See, I'll just show you.
Yes.
Google. Okay. Buy iPhone 7. So here you can see ad, right? And at the bottom also you can see the ad. And when I go to other page, the second page, here also I can see ads, but not the text ad. Text ad is not showing right now. Okay, so ads come on third page, fourth page, fifth page, but we want to have the ad on first page or at the top or
okay.
at the bottom. Okay, if you want.
Yeah.
So they have given you two options. Top of the first result page, that is at the top, which will come on number one here. Or you can select anywhere.
Okay.
Anywhere on the first result page. Anywhere means anywhere in this page, either on the top or at the bottom. Okay, you just want your ad
on different page.
Sorry?
If I'm going to select the second option, I can see my ad on the first in the first but on different pages.
No, on first page only, but at different place. Yeah. Not on. It can show at the top also, second number, third number, or at the bottom also. Anywhere on this first page only, but on first. Page. Yes.
Okay. No problem.
These are very advanced level settings. Okay, and Google is really going to charge high amount for this. Okay, then you have cost per acquisition, which is
target. Okay, how?
Sorry.
Do you think how much are they charging for this?
That really depends on the keywords that you're targeting. So as I told you, if the keyword is competitive, then they can go for 500,000 rupees also for one keyword. 500 rupees to 700 rupees for one click. Yes. So that is a lot of money, you see, that you end up paying.
Yeah, per click.
Per click, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Then we have target CPA, which is cost per acquisition. Target AdWords uses a target this that you enter and automatically sets bid to help get as many conversions as possible. So now here when we select CPA, the system will select the conversions. On conversions, they are going to pay. They are going to charge us.
Okay.
Okay, for this, we need to select on the conversion tracking. Conversion tracking so that system can track each and every sale that is made from our website. Okay, and on each sale, AdWords will charge on each sale.
Okay.
So that is very expensive. So it says some conversions may cost more or less than your target CPA. So if I set my target CPA, okay, so let's say my budget is 2,000 rupees, they can go more also, less also per sale.
Okay.
Then you have target return on ad spend. Like as I told you, return on investment. You remember return on investment?
Yeah, ROI.
Similarly here, return on ad spend. So let's say if I am spending 1,000 rupees on my ad, I will ask AdWords that please give me 10% of what I'm spending.
Okay.
Okay. So these are very, you know, next level things or the advanced level things, which will not be used much. You know, these are
okay.
These are launched by Google in these last 2-3 months only. They were not earlier. Earlier only okay. Automated and manual was there. Rest is just launched. Okay. So I would first request you to first go with maximized clicks and manual CPC. Try creating the ad and see the result. And then we can, you know, look for the other options. Because it will just confuse you.
Okay.
Make sense?
Yes, yes.
So we in our students also, we just teach them manual and maximize clicks. That in their advanced learning, once they are comfortable with manual and automated clicks, then we come up with the teach them all these you know, advanced bidding.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, so let's start with manual CPC. Let's set the manual one.
Okay.
Okay, here. So our bid is 100 and budget is 1000. Correct?
Yes.
This we have set. Now moving forward, there are some ad extensions. Have you ever seen ad extensions? You know what ad extensions? Okay. So let us just find some ad here. Okay. Can you see this ad?
Which one?
This ad.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So these are some extensions.
Okay.
And you might have seen the option which comes for call. They give you a number and you directly click and call on mobile when you get these ads. Okay. So that is called call extension.
Call extension.
Yeah. If you get to see the address, if Apple is showing the address here, you know, you get to see number of ads where address is also shown. Yeah. That is location extension. Location extension. Okay, do you have a smartphone like iPhone right now?
Yes.
Okay, go to Google.
1 second. Google, okay.
Yeah. Oh, just a sec. Okay, let me just see the keyword on which that is. Can you find any local restaurant?
In our place?
Yes, yes. Type in Google.
Let's say Burger King. Burger King Dubai.
Sorry, which one?
Okay. Burger King. Burger King.
Burger King. Okay, let me look for Burger King.
Yeah, like there's a call button here.
Yeah, call and directions, and you can see that.
Yeah, directions. Yes, yes, yes. I can see it like from
there. Have all extensions basically.
So,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so when I understand
create,
now.
Yeah. So yes. When you create the ad, so you know, adding the extensions will make our ad copy more relevant. Okay. Google really value if we add all these extensions because it shows that yes, we are reliable. Okay. Reliable in the sense because we are sharing our location also, we are sharing our number also. So we are not fake people. Right? And if we extensions, our getting a chance to rank on first page is higher.
Okay.
Okay, because that's this is also a part of the quality score, ad extensions.
Okay.
Okay. So when I select location, your account doesn't have any location. I click on add now. I'll now add a location here.
Okay.
Okay. So you can go to business, Google My Business, manage your locations in. I told you the business submission. I can add. I have told you about how you can add your business to Google. How you can register your location in Google Business in my last class. Places. Do you remember maps?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. So yes, from there you can manage.
Yeah, Google Maps.
Yes. They're giving our existing business. Actually, one of my ad is already running, so it is already verified. Actually, to register your location, you can first go to google.com businesses. Why it's giving me this page? I think they have changed something, because earlier we used to get
si Gabba. Ano naman yun? Paano ka?
Just sign it out. Okay, so coming back to campaign here, actually I was logged in from different account in my business account. So now I have logged in from a fresh account, which is this.
Okay.
Okay. So when you click on this, you see the drop down.
Okay.
Click on go to Google My Business. Okay. Here, because I'm logged in from different account, I'll just change the account. Uh, Okay, so here I don't see any of my location registered. Okay, this is for different business. And now to add a location, can you see this plus sign? Plus button?
Yes.
Click on that. Here, you get to see.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Add a location. Okay. Okay, so now here you're going to give you the business name. So you remember this page I've shown you last time?
Yes, yes, I remember now.
Yeah, yeah. So this was I shown you. Once you registered your business, I told you that you're going to receive the code also from Google when you register your business.
Yes.
Okay, right now yeah. I'm putting my company name here because I have the address. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'll give the business phone number. Okay, let me give my category, digital marketing, advertising agency.
PIN code is, pretty PIN code is the same as the postal code, right?
Yeah, yeah, it's the same.
Okay.
It is called PIN code, zip code, postal code, different names.
Okay.
So I have given this. So to manage the business on Google, verify this information. So to verify, I'm authorized to manage this business and I agree. Okay, I'll say continue. So now to verify, they will send me a code at my place. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so can you see this? By post to this, they will send me a post. Okay, when if I click post, so okay. I will receive a code by post on my address. Okay, so this is how you can.
Okay, so how many days?
Within 1-2 days.
Pretty?
Yeah.
2 days.
1 or 2 days, yes. Maximum 2 days.
2 days, correct? Okay. 2 days.
Yeah, yeah. Maximum 2 days.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm not posting it right now. I'll just do verify later, okay?
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. So now you know how you can add location extension.
Yes, yes.
Okay, great.
Yes.
Okay, so coming back here. So I just cancel this as of now. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then you have site links. Extend my ads with links to sections of my site. So if you have a website, okay, let's say Luxury Rose is your website and you have different web pages, like for birthday flowers, you have a different page. Anniversary flowers, you have a different page. Valentine flowers, you have a different page, right? So let's say we are promoting here okay. the Valentine thing, okay? So you can select 4 site links, okay? No site links are available right now. Okay, add new site link. Link text here, so let's say Valentine. So you can see here the word limit, 25 is the word limit. Can you see this in the link text?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, so this yes. is the word limit here, okay?
Okay.
So link text, I will mention here, Valentine. Okay, and I'll give the final URL. Let's say www.luxury rose, Valentine gift, luxury rose dot online, and let's say your web page is Valentine page, right? Makes sense?
Yes. Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, if you want to device preference, you can select mobile. Okay, if you don't want to show on mobile, then deselect.
Okay.
You can give the description also. It is recommended. If you want to describe by Valentine gifts now. Okay. You can give from which date and time you want to show these links. Because see, people will come to you, come to the website at night also. Let's say you are not operational at night. So you can say, you can just set the morning scheduling, right? See, okay. You can set the time.
Okay.
Okay. Clear? So these are the tracking template that you can add here. The tracking template like landing page. If you have different landing page here for this tracking. But we are just going with the link within website and you can save it. Description. Okay, we need to give more. See, this is how it's gonna show.
Okay.
Yeah, can you see here? You can add four, maximum four links of your website.
Okay.
Okay. Getting it clear?
What do you mean by, yeah, what do you mean pretty by four links, like the page links, right?
Site links, yes, web page links. So if I show you this ad, can you see this? Compare iPhone models. These are site links. So when I click here, okay, these are links to the website, but different page. See, I can compare.
Yeah, on a particular, yeah, but on a...
Yes?
Yes.
So these are the links that you can give in your ad campaign. Yeah. So if I want to see product red, it will show me the red phone, red color phone. See? These,
yes.
Yeah, different link within same website, basically. I'm into Apple only, but web page is different.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so these are the site links. Sorry, where are we? Okay, here. Now you have call extension. You can add your phone number, mobile number. Okay, so you can add new number.
Okay.
You can give the phone number. You can select from which country. You can select Dubai or I can select India. Dubai is UAE, right? Yeah, UAE.
Yes.
Okay. So let me just select India. Okay, now I can give my number. They will verify it. Call reporting is on. If I click advance, I can set the timings also when I want my number to be displayed with ad. Okay.
Should I not click the device preference on the mobile?
It should only be shown on mobile because that will make more sense because people can directly call.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because for using their laptop, so that's
Yes. Yeah, you're right here. Then you can specify the start date, end date, and the timings also, because you don't want people to call you at night hours. Okay, so you can set 9 to 5, 9 to 6, 10 to 5, that way. Okay?
Okay, sure. Yeah.
So this is how your number is added. Okay.
Okay.
Callouts are the additional descriptive text which you can write. I'll just show you here the example of callouts. Can you see here? These are just, we are just mentioning like EMI options available, delightful prices, free and easy returns, right? Or
yes.
This is like callout up to 20,000 off on exchange, best offer on iPhone 7, buy it today from Flipkart.
Okay.
Okay. Sorry, that is description. This is description. But this is, yeah, call. These are the callouts. Okay. You can add new callout. Callout text, fresh flowers. Okay, this is how you can structured snippets. It's almost same, extend my ad with structured snippets. Like again, you're giving the USP of your product. You're telling people to come and buy. Let's say, it is almost call out a free and easy returns. Okay, where you are motivating people, writing that EMI options available.
So they're almost the same.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so you can add new. You can highlight that header in English. Okay, so if you want to give the brand name or any degree program, you can just give that. You know, value. Values 1, 2, 3. So flower in flower case, can you give some good points? Like why they want it. Okay. So this is how your callouts will be added. Okay. And it will really going to add value to your campaign or the ad that you're going to run. And Google.
Okay.
Yeah, Google will probably rank your ad on page one at the top, so that creates the high probability. Okay, clear?
Okay, yes, yeah, clear.
So, yeah, any doubt in here?
I just only want to ask you, Preeti.
Sure.
If for Google AdWords, is there unlimited keywords we can use for this one? Or we will go back again to SEO?
Sorry, the limited keywords you're talking about?
Yes, yes, yes.
No,
for example, hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
I just only want to ask if is there like unlimited keywords we can use like for this campaign for Google AdWords, or we will still go back to what is the rules or the discussion we have mentioned for SEO?
No, see here, you can select as many keywords as you want for a particular set of ad group, I would say. Okay, we are going to come on ad group now. Our next part is ad group. And on each ad group, you can set number of keywords.
Okay.
There is no limit as such. But it is always good to target limited keywords so that you can track. It will become easy for you only to track.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
So once I make the save and continue, once I press this, then my ad will automatically run now.
No, right now we need to add keywords also, a lot more things to be done. This is
okay.
The area that we have covered.
Okay.
Now,
yeah.
From this, now next part we are going to do after the break, lunch break.
Okay.
Yeah, the rest of the settings.
No problem.
Okay, so do you have any doubt till here?
No, it's all clear.
All clear. So I'll just continue as of now for this part. And now after this, now we are going to do the ad groups, which we are going to do after the break, 45 minutes.
Okay. Yes, no problem. So after 45 minutes, we will start again for this one.
Yes, definitely. So hope if you can do also in this time, if you have time. And if you have any doubt, then we will clear it after the break.
Yes. Yeah. No problem.
Clear?
Yep. Yes, clear.
Okay, great, Maria. Hope to get
bye.
Break. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Bye. Kaya nga ni tapos ako pa ito na si Auntie Marlene nagangayo pa. Apo, mamaya na lang, may. Sige, sige. Apo, sige, mami. Bye-bye. Okay, nag-ay, aram, si Daddy, nagpaayos na naman sa motor. Oh. Kaya gusto naman mag-ayos sa kwarta sa aton. Sabi ko, mami, kaya una, nagsabi, kaya nag-message talaga ni si Daddy sa akon sa nakaagi. Ang sabi niya, di daw ako nag-reply. Kita, ah, nag-reply ako sa message niya. Sabi ho. Sabi ho.
Mami, hindi nag-reply.
Yan. Kaya di rin, nag-reply man ako, nabasa ko, sabi ko sa inya. Sabi ni mami, ano doon si daddy, pag nag-ayo doon ko ng kwarta, di nang nagre-reply. Sabi ko, mami, nag-aipon pa no kami, didi, san ano, san pag-uli. Oh, sabi ko, kung gusto nyo, ipadara ko na lang talan ko ng kwarta, didi, di rin ako mauli. Sabi ko sa iya, kaya paano man lang yan, para padara ko ang kwarta ko, didi na lang ako mauli. Ipadara ko na lang talan ko, didi na kwarta. Nagtawa-tawa si mami. Isa yung paayos, may lunch, may motor na naman baga. Nag-ano na naman sa motor? Ano motor?
Okay, I'll make sure that you get the recordings, Rehma.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
But right now, we have moved really ahead. You can ask Maria that we have already covered SEO. SEO was complete in our last class. And today we are doing Google AdWords, okay, where we run campaigns on Google, the search engine. So right now we are in the middle of creating a campaign on Google AdWords, okay, which I'm showing case practically to Maria. And here half of the campaign is created. Now we are on the second half.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know whether you now be able to understand this because theoretically I have covered in my last class and today we are doing practical.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
if you're comfortable, you can look what we are on, and in case because you need to see the recordings first, only then things will get clear to you now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, not a problem. You want me to brief you like what we are doing right now?
Okay.
Yeah. Maria, is it okay with you, Maria?
Yeah, no problem. Sure.
Okay, we'll just brief her in 10-15 minutes.
Sorry?
I'll just brief her, Rehma, for another 10-15 minutes.
Yes, no problem. Just give me a buzz once we will go ahead with our topic.
Okay, sure.
Okay?
Sure, yeah.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay, Rehma, I am on Google AdWords basically. So you know the ads, right? Google ads, which we run on Google platform. This is search engine.
Yes.
Okay. And here we run ads. And for these ads, we pay amount to Google.
Yes.
So today I'm teaching Rehma, this Maria, how to create the ad on Google AdWords. Okay, so here we have created the campaign where we have set the type of campaign that we are creating, like search ad or the display ad. There are two type of ads that we can create, search ad or display ad. Search ad are those ads which we can create on search engine like these ads. And display ads are the those ads which comes on different website. I hope you remember this. In my last class, I have told you about the display ads. The ads which are showing here on the NDTV, this ad is called display ad.
Yeah.
Because this is coming on different platform, on different website. Okay, it's not coming on search engine. That's the reason they are called display ads. So there is a difference between search ad and the display ad.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is one type. Then when you create a campaign, you need to set the bidding also. Okay. Like how much you want to bid for the keywords. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So, yeah, we set the bidding. There are two ways that we set the bidding. I'll just show you. These are the ways through which you can set the bidding. One is the manual CPC, automated clicks. Manual means you manually set the bid. Okay.
What?
Bid means how much you are willing to pay to Google on every click. Okay.
Yeah. So,
yeah, when I click on this ad, okay, Apple is going to pay to Google on this click because Apple has got a click and this will be paid to Google. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so this bidding we need to set. We need to give the amount that we are willing to pay for one click. Okay, and we can keep changing as and when we want. We can change bid at any point in time.
Okay.
Okay, in automated clicks, like maximize clicks, we give authority to AdWords, like Google AdWords, we give them authority to keep changing the bid. They can set their bid, they can set bid on our behalf. Okay, and there we need to enter or make changes because we have given authority to AdWords to set the bid and they can keep changing as and when required. This is all automated. No manual intervention will be there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then the other is maximize CPA, which is cost per conversion acquisition. Cost per acquisition. Okay, this means acquisition. Okay, just this. Okay, and here this means that cost per sale. Here you are going to pay Google on each sale or conversion. Okay, it can be sale, it can be subscription, it can be registration, depending on the conversion that you are looking for. On that basis, you are going to pay. Here, you are not going to pay Google for click. For click, you are not going to pay. You are going to pay on sale. Okay? On every sale. Let's say someone comes here and click on iPhone 7, this.
Yeah.
Okay? So, they will not pay on this click if they make sale. Okay? If they buy it. Buy now. They click on buy and make a purchase, then they are going to pay to Google here.
Okay, okay.
Okay, make sense?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So this is what we are doing. Okay, and there are certain settings that we need to do. So these are the steps then that we take when we create an ad. First, you create a campaign. You name the campaign. Name a campaign, okay. And then you select the type of campaign, whether you want to create a search ad, or you want to create a display ad. Display ad. Hope now you understand the difference, or you want to create both. Okay, based on this, you select. So we are currently creating a search ad as of now. Then you select the location where you want to target. Yeah. Sorry?
Yeah, I'm moving.
Okay, great. And then you select a location where you want to target the audience. Okay, so if you want to target Dubai, then you can select Dubai. Okay, the location will be set as Dubai. Okay, then language, you can select language, Arabic or English or only English or any other language. Yeah?
Yes.
Then bidding. So then we select bidding, and we also specify the daily budget, like how much you are willing to spend. Okay. So let's say, for example, here in bidding, we select manual. Okay. Manually, we are going to set the bid, which is CPC, which is cost per click. We are manually setting it. So here in bid, we give 100. So we are willing to pay 100 rupees for each click, and our budget is equal to 1000. This is our daily budget. There is an option of setting daily budget. So can you tell me how many clicks you are going to get in a day? Number of clicks you are going to get out of this? Can you tell me how many clicks you are going to get?
For 1000?
Yes, if your budget is 1000 rupees, 1000 bucks, and you are bidding for 100, like 100, you are going to pay to Google for each click, and your budget is 1000, how many clicks you are going to get?
10?
Click, yeah, exactly, correct. So you're going to get 10 clicks. Perfect, Rema. Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the whole criteria. So if you increase the budget, then your number of clicks will also increase. Okay. And if you get 10 clicks in a day, then your ad will stop and it will continue the other day. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So you also need to know what is the objective of your campaign. That is very important. Why you want to run your campaign, whether you want to have more traffic to your website, okay, or you want more conversions or sales. Okay, if you want only traffic, if you're only concerned with the traffic on your website, then you can go for either manual CPC or automated maximized clicks. These are the options that you can go for in case of traffic. And in case of conversion, if you're only looking for conversions, then you can go for CPA, cost per acquisition. Okay?
Okay.
Clear? Any doubt, anything which is not getting clear, Rehma, please, you can ask me.
Okay.
Because I'm just revising it with you, and once you see the video, then things will get more clear to you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. So this is what we have done till now. We have also set the ad extensions. Ad extensions, like when you search for the ad. Sorry. Okay, so here, can you see these text? These are called ad extension. Okay?
Yeah.
So ad extensions can be like where you are just showing, where you can just show. Like you can show phone number, call extension, you can have call extension. You can have location extension where you can show the address of your business. Okay.
Okay.
And you can have a site links where you can show web pages of your website. Web pages of your website. Okay. So there are some other also which we have already discussed, and you can see these are the main site links which I used. Okay. And similarly in bidding also, these are the main bidding criteria or strategies which are used. There are some other strategies also launched by Google. Okay, but that are all advanced level. I would request you to first start with the manual or the automated maximize click bidding and then go further. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so these are the things that we have covered now. And this is the document from our last class, which I will share with you guys, okay? And now I'll just call Maria to join us.
Okay.
Maria, you can join us.
Okay.
Okay, great, Maria. Maria, you have any doubt?
No, it's all clear.
You sure?
Yep.
Okay. You're clear with the bidding part?
Yes.
Yes. And ad extensions, any doubt?
No. Ad extension, no.
No? Okay.
Yep.
Okay, so shall we move forward then?
Yes.
Okay, great. So now coming back to our campaign. Okay, so after saving Rehma, after we have saved our half of the campaign, now we have reached on the second part of the campaign. Okay, we have done the settings, right, Maria? We have done the settings. Now we are on ad groups.
Correct. Yes, correct.
Okay, I hope you understand the ad groups that we have covered in my last class.
Yes, it's the relevant content.
The ad campaign, ad within ad groups, you can have keywords and ad copy.
Mm.
Remember?
Yes.
So this is the example that we have taken. So let's say you are running a campaign on flower delivery. And we are making ad group, and ad group is related to birthday deliveries, and these are the set of keywords for this ad group. Okay, yeah. Can be multiple keywords for one ad group and one ad copy.
Okay.
Okay, and similarly, if you create another ad group, there you are like for you're creating for Valentine flower delivery, and then the keywords will be different.
Okay.
Okay, you remember now?
Yes.
Okay, and then put the ad copy.
For the ad copy, what we will put for the ad copy?
Ad copy means the content, the text. Like here, this is the ad copy, iPhone 7 Plus. This is the headline. This is the landing page. And this is the description, right? This is the ad
So the title is the ad copy?
No, the complete ad. Can you see this complete
ad? Yeah.
This is called ad copy. Okay?
Yes. Clear.
So for each group, we are going to have set of keywords and an ad copy. Make sense?
Yep.
Okay, Rehma, is it getting clear?
Yes.
Okay. So here we are creating an ad, okay, for the flower, like Valentine. We are making a campaign for Maria, as she is into sending flowers delivery. Okay, so here we are creating a Valentine campaign where we send flowers to the loved ones. Okay, so now we are going to write here, enter your landing page first. Okay, so here we are going to type in the landing page. Maria, do you have a landing page right now?
For my flower shop?
Yeah, for your flower shop and the Valentine, something on gifts and occasions.
Luxuryrose.online.
.online, okay.
Yes.
That is your link. And the key ad campaign as we are running for Valentine. So do you have any specific web page for that?
No, I don't think so. No. I didn't create it.
Any gifts or occasions related page? Okay, so let's say hypothetically this exists, okay? Let's say. Sorry. We are taking hypothetical situation that this page exists, okay?
Yes, yes.
Okay, now when I click on add group here, get ad group ideas, okay, enter your product or services. So here I'm going to add this product, which is flower delivery. Okay, this is my now.
Preeti, should I ask? Okay, sorry.
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah, should I add that Valentine word, like should I mention everything, like the specific page, or is it fine that to mention only the URL?
No, you have to specify the landing page. See here, what we're doing is we are promoting our Valentine campaign, okay?
And yeah.
And if we make people land on our home page, then it will not look attractive and they will just go haywire. And because we want them to reach directly on our web page from where they can place the order.
Okay.
Yeah, you're getting me? So we have to be very specific here.
Okay,
so this is the delivery flower. So now here you can select the keywords. Can you see here?
Yep.
So now system is suggesting us the keywords. Okay. So here deliver flowers. There are plus 68 keywords. Flower delivery, flowers for delivery, flowers to be delivered. There are 20 keywords for this. Same day flower delivery, florist delivery. So let's say same day flower delivery. We have selected. This is now our ad copy. Ad group.
Okay.
That is same day flower delivery. We have select the ad group. That is, we are going to deliver flowers on the same day. Clear?
Yes.
And now we are going to select the keywords for this. Can you see these keywords that we have got?
Yes, quite a lot.
Sorry?
Quite a lot.
Quite a lot. And tip is also coming. Start with 10 to 20 keywords per ad group. Right? So now here you can select. Let's say, just a sec. You can edit, you can delete. Okay, so let's say I have selected same day flower delivery, right? Okay, it has gone to this. Now I can remove same day flower delivery is one, same day delivery flowers, flower delivery same day flowers, same day. Okay, overnight flower delivery. Okay, so let's say I'll just delete the rest. And these are the ones that I have kept.
Okay.
Okay, for this ad group. Okay, and I can change the bid also, but I have kept the bid 100 for these keywords.
Preeti.
Yeah.
You already set a budget before, when we are discussing the first two parts of the campaign. And now you're putting again another bid of 100 rupees. So is it another cost, another charge?
No. Actually, what is happening here, the bid that I have added 100, system is showing the same again here. Because at this level also, you can change the bid for these set of keywords.
Okay.
It is showing me again, but it is not going to charge again. Remains same, yeah. So if I change here to 80 rupees, so that will be updated.
Okay,
what we can do here again, for these keywords, I am bidding 80 rupees, okay. Now when I add a new ad group here, I can add multiple ad groups, okay, within one campaign. Okay, now my next ad group is going to be on birthday deliveries. Okay.
Yes.
So here I have selected birthday delivery, and now let's say flower delivery on birthday, right? I'm going to get the ideas from Google here. See here, you are getting the ideas, right?
Yep.
Okay, so let's say I'll select birthday flowers and gifts, okay? So let's select this and I can see the keywords. Can you see these keywords?
Yep.
From here only, let's say I'll just deselect all the keywords and I'm now going to select single keywords. Okay. These are the keywords that I want to track. Now I'll do add. Oh, doesn't come. Okay, it comes in my lower this thing. Okay, so I'll just delete this. Yeah. So can you see now? This is one campaign for same delivery flower. Same day flower delivery on Valentine occasion. And this is for birthday flowers and gifts. And these are the different campaign keywords. And now on these keywords, I can bid different amount.
So this will be an extra charge, right?
No. See, if people come and look for birthday flowers, right? And then they will be charged 50 rupees. We will pay 50 rupees for that click on these keywords. Okay?
Okay.
But as these keywords are very competitive, let's say, for example, then if people come and click on this, we are willing to pay 80 rupees for this. You're getting the difference?
Okay. Yes.
You can set bid on keywords, basically. Okay. It's not that you just set 80, 100 rupees for all the keywords. No, you can change it as per the keywords also. Okay.
Okay.
Making sense? You can create n number of ad groups here within a one campaign. You can create multiple ad groups. Now you can create more ad groups here. Third one. Keep two only for to keep it simple.
How much is the maximum ad groups that I can make in one campaign?
Sorry, how many ad groups? You can create n number of ad groups.
Okay.
Okay, multiple. Yeah. Clear?
Yes, no limit.
Yeah, there's no limit, but people will not create that many groups so that they confused. Maximum would be like 4 to 5. You can go for 4 to 5 so that it will be easy for you also to keep a track of all your ad groups here, right? Okay, makes sense.
Yes.
You can create. So system is basically giving you all the ideas. You can see that. All the keywords also. And you can select from the set of keywords. And based on specific keywords, you can set your bid. Right? Any doubt till here?
No.
No now? Sure? No.
Yep.
You want me to create one more ad group?
Yes.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. So we add new ad group here. So can you see the options? Now I'll change here. And let's say we'll select Valentine cards. Okay, Valentine cards. And I'll search. So these are the areas. So let's say Valentine greeting cards are the one, and I'll select keywords from here, let's say. Okay, let's say Lover's Day greeting. Valentine card wishes. Right, these are the ones that I have selected and created. Now here I can bid other amount for this, like 80. Okay?
Yeah.
Making sense?
Mm.
You can add n number of keywords, but good to be 10 to 15 keywords only.
Yes.
Rehma, is it making sense to you?
Yes.
Okay. Are you with us?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sure. So now I'll continue to add. So now can you see this? Now we have achieved campaign settings. We have done. We have created our ad group. Now we are going to create ad. This is called ad copy now.
Mm.
Maria, this will be ad copy, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, here we are going to give the final URL of your website, which is luxuryrose.online, okay?
Mm.
And now headline. I'm going to give the headline. Celebrate Valentine.
So it's giving you the right side, giving you the how it looks like.
Like, exactly.
Okay.
Now, can you see the word limit also? This is 30. And I have explained. Okay. Send Valentine gift. Okay. Same again, 30. Send Valentine gift to your loved ones. Right?
Yes.
Now, we are going to give the part. Let's say the path is Valentine only. Can you see this? Luxuryrose.online Valentine.
This is the web page, right?
Yes, the web page.
This is the web page, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. And now you're going to give the description. Description will be like, clear?
Mm.
So here the limit is 80.
Okay,
here in headline you can give 30 characters. Headline 2 you are going to give 30 characters. Description you can give 80 characters. Okay, let me write it in the document also for you guys.
Yes, please.
Okay, bidding, then budget, and then we have done the ad groups, okay, where we have selected keywords. Okay, now ad copy. In ad copy, we headline 1, 30 word limit. Headline 2, 30 again word limit. Then description is 80. Yeah.
Oy. Yes, clear. Carlo.
So it will be look like this. Right?
Yes.
Moving ahead. So we can copy this ad copy to more ad groups. If we want to make the same ad for all the, whereas we can set the different, create ad, another ad. So can you see now?
Yes. What do you mean by this?
This means, you know, we have created three ad groups. Same day flower delivery, one is that, birthday flowers and gifts, second is that, Valentine greeting cards is third ad group, right?
Yeah.
We can use the same ad copy. Okay, let me show you previous page. Let me go back. Okay, here. Okay, continue to ads. Okay, now I'm in the same page here. Okay, here when I'll click, this is the ad that I have created. Right? I can see this ad for only this keyword, this same day flower delivery. Ad group, you remember?
Yes.
See in this document. Okay, here in the document, I told you for each ad group, you can have set of keywords and one ad copy for each ad group. Right now, we have just created for one ad group, the ad for one ad group. Yes? For this ad group, okay? Now, we need to create ad for this birthday flowers and gifts also.
Yes.
Okay, so we are going to create the ad for this. So can you see now birthday flowers and gifts is the ad group?
Preeti, I just want to ask, what is the importance like making a different ad groups? Does it like give you an assurance that you will get like more conversions for your campaign?
Okay, see here. Let's see, you have one campaign which is going on for Valentine, okay?
Yes.
You can say for birthdays, okay? But you have different web pages for that. Okay. Now our final URL will be different for this.
Okay.
So when people look for birthday flowers and gifts and for these keywords, then this ad copy will show up.
Ah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And if they say search for this keyword, then this ad copy will show up.
So according to the keywords that people is going to search, your ad will also be there. Like for example, if they click for the same day flower delivery on that page, your website will be there.
Yes.
And then if they're going to search for birthday flowers and gifts, your ad will be there.
Yes, yes, yes. And we, as we have said, the different bid also. Have you seen? We have sent a different bid.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now making sense. Some clearance is coming.
Yes, yes, yes.
And you can do one more thing, Maria, here. You can create multiple ad copies, like two.
Carlo.
Sorry?
No, no, sorry, sorry.
Okay. So you can create multiple ad copies for one set of keywords or one ad group. This will happen like at some point in time, this ad will come and the other point in time, this ad will come. This will show you how much clicks you are getting on this ad, or if it is not working, how many clicks you are getting on the other ad, so that you can stop this ad and you can work on this ad copy only. This is for testing purposes, basically. You can see, you can compare which ad is doing good for you. Okay, so let me create one more ad copy. Okay, these are unsaved. Let me save these changes. Oh. Okay, so now I can create another ad for the same keyword. Okay, ad group. Let's say I'll change the URL will remain same, but the content will be different. Headline one here. Valentine's special. Valentine's special. Long delivery on same day. Right? You getting the difference? And path.
Yes, yes.
Path here same Valentine. Now
Preeti, the path you mentioned here, like for example, the Valentine you mentioned here, Valentine. This Valentine should, the landing page should be like, be there also on my website, right?
Exactly.
For this Valentine.
Yes, 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 only then.
Hello?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Can you hear me?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, I can hear you now.
Okay, so now, can you see, now we have created two ad copies here. Can you see the difference?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
So when people are going to look for these keywords, so you might be, you know, want to know which ad will show at what areas, right? So this will depend, like at some point in time, this ad will come. And at some point in time, this ad will come. In your analysis, you get to see which ad is working good for you, how many clicks they are getting for you. Okay, if people are clicking on this ad more, then you keep this ad and you remove this.
Ah, okay. So I can easily remove, like for example,
you can delete. Can you
after some time?
Yeah, yeah, after some time, you can delete.
Mm.
And you can make 3 to 4 or more copies of your ad copy.
Okay.
Now for another ad group, you can create the ad. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, I'll give you the access now. I want you to enter the details here.
Okay.
Okay. You got the control, remote control?
1 second.
Okay, I'll just give you. Yes, I have given you now. Okay, mention here, keeping in mind the birthday flowers and gifts. Rema, are you there? Yeah, next you are going to create, Rema.
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah.
Why can't erase? That's not for me. Hello. Online. And then, where is it? No.
Just leave this. There is some change in the page. I'll just come back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Here it is. Yes.
You cannot. Pretty, I can't type. Hello?
You're not working on the ad? Is you facing some problem?
Yes. Actually, I'm a different page now. Okay, it's working now.
Yeah.
Birthday. There you go.
Okay, great. Now save it. Scroll down. Okay.
Create ad, right?
Yeah, create ad. Okay, so now there you get to see.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so now I'll just give the access to Rehma to create an ad.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. Rehma, you have got the control.
What?
You have got the control, remote control. Now you can move your mouse and use your keyword, okay?
Okay.
Okay, now come to Valentine greeting cards down. Click on plus button and create an ad copy there. Yes, yes, there. Exactly. Yeah, click on final your, yes, yes. So your ad group is Valentine greeting cards. Accordingly, you can create the ad copy. Make sure you use the capital letter of your first word. Yes, has to be capital so that it looks more appealing.
the?
Yes, give the path of your website page. Also give a brief description in the description.
What should I write?
Path is actually the end landing page where your user will come. So here you can give cards, like greeting cards or cards. The web page of your website, the name of your web page. Just don't type www. Just type greeting cards. Like cards. Yeah. Okay, that's it. Okay, you don't give space. In the URL, don't give space, yes. Okay, so this is the URL and this ad copy is created. Okay, now click on create ad, scroll down. Yes, click on create ad. Okay, guys, clear? Is it clear, guys?
Yes.
Yes, Rehma and Maria?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Moving ahead, now we'll click on review campaign. So now our estimate is, budget is 1,000 rupees. Daily estimate. Okay, and campaign settings like location, we have selected Abu Dhabi, Dubai, Google search. Only because this is search network and English and Arabic language. Okay.
Okay.
And here we have got same day flower delivery. This is the ad group name. And this group we have bid for 100 rupees, and these are our keywords. Okay, and this is the ad copy. We have created two ad copies. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, birthday flowers and gifts. This we are bidding for this much amount. And these are the keywords. And this is again the other ad group. You can click on edit in case you want to edit at this stage. Okay. This is the icon for editing. Clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay. So I'll click on save and finish. Now, So can you see this? The campaign is created. Ad group, okay. So from here, you are going to track the status, right? For this ad group.
So like this is done for.
Sorry.
This is the report.
This is the report. Yeah, kind of report.
Report.
Here you can see keywords also. This is on keywords now. And you can see the clicks that you are going to get. Number of clicks will be shown here. Number of impressions, like number of views you are getting. And what's the CTR rate?
Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me? Guys, can you hear me? Please leave the mouse, guys. Please leave the mouse. Okay, let me just take the control now. Okay. Yes, can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Rema can hear me. Maria, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So I was telling you, you can see here. So firstly, let's go back. These are the ad group. Can you see ad group? Ad group. Yeah, these are the three ad groups that we have created. Okay. Clear?
Yeah.
Guys?
Yeah.
Okay, now when I click on this, I'll come to keywords. Can you see keywords? These are the keywords that we have selected for that ad group. Okay, and here when we come to keyword, here we get to see how many clicks we are getting. The CTR, which is click-through rate. CPC, the conversion. Okay, so the average cost per click and the actual cost here and your position. Make sense?
Yeah.
Your voice is not clear, Mario. Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, Maria, your voice not clear.
I think the network is not.
Yes. There is echo.
Yeah, the network, I think.
Hello. Rema, can you hear Maria?
No.
Yeah. Okay. So it's the problem.
Just voice is an echo.
Yeah. There is an echo.
Hello,
Maria.
Yes, can you hear me now?
Yeah, now we can.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes.
So, did you get my message?
Okay, have you sent the message? Message? No, can you repeat?
Like the chat. I ask you, how about we want to extend the campaign?
Sorry, can you type it in the chat window? I I didn't receive it in chat window. Can you type it again?
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, did you receive it?
No, I didn't.
Okay, my question is, I'll just tell you. How about you want to extend the campaign?
How to extend the campaign?
Yes.
Okay. So you can extend the date of the campaign and then it will be extended, the same campaign will be extended. Sorry, I can't hear you.
I'm not saying anything.
Okay, you got my point?
No, can you please repeat it again? Sorry.
Okay, I said when you change the date and time, your campaign will be extended to further. Okay. Sorry. Not able to hear you. Same problem I'm getting, which I was getting in the morning. Hello. Hello. Maria, I'm not been able to hear you. No, it's not okay. Are you not been able to type in the chat window? Sorry. Can you try joining in again?
Okay, sure.
Now I can hear you. Wait. Maria?
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Yeah.
So where should I go to check or to extend the schedule of the campaign? Okay.
So here, can you see this message? Your account is not active. To activate your account and start running your ads, enter your billing information. Okay. So when you enter the billing information, then your campaign will start. Then system will ask you to enter the date on which you want to start and end. And after, when you come back, you can extend from there. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So these are the campaign. You can create number of campaigns, right? How about we, where should we go to extend the campaign? Okay. You can go to settings to change ad groups firstly. All settings. Okay, to change the budget, you can go here. Okay, Maria, can you see this edit button within settings? You can change the budget at any point, but to extend the campaign, that will be done when the campaign will actually start. And it will only start when the credit card details are there.
Yeah.
Yes. So, but you can change the budget. Information you want to change, you want to change the location, language, bidding, that you can change here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
By going into settings and all settings.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
And now here are your ads that you have created. Right.
Yeah, Preeti, I have one more question.
Sure, go ahead. Again, your one is a problem, Maria. Can you type in? Yeah, Maria. Yes. Can't hear you. I think better would be to rejoin so that this problem gets solved. Maria, can you rejoin? We can take 10 minutes, 5 minutes break, and then we can start. Rehma? Rehma, you there?
Yes, I'm there.
Okay.
I'm here.
Yeah, I got it now, Maria.